Hello friends, today we will discuss 11 techniques that every software professional should know. The first one is abstraction, second is encapsulation, third is information hiding, fourth is modularization, then we have separation of concerns, fifth one, sixth is coupling and cohesion, seventh technique is sufficiency, completeness, and primitiveness. Eighth technique is separation of policy and implementation. And ninth is separation of interface and implementation. Tenth is single point of reference. And the final 11th technique is divide and conquer. Let's start with abstraction. What is abstraction? Abstraction is a technique that we human use when we are dealing with complexity. We focus on only on the aspects of any object that we are interested in. We don't worry about the details. Let me give you an example. Let's take a healthcare domain. A patient, he goes to the hospital, that is called encounter, and then he is diagnosed with problems and some procedures are operated. So let's say patient, if we are building a system which will give us a history of the patient, how many times he was in the hospital, what diagnosis he had, what kind of procedures he had, we would not care about his address, his car, whether he has some insurance or not, because these aspects are more important to the billing. So we abstract the information only we are interested. So patient, what are the key characteristics of patient that separated from encounter? And we are interested only that information of patient which we need for our system. So we are identifying the key abstractions in our system like patient. So these are called entity abstractions like patient, encounter, procedures. These are entity abstractions. There are another abstraction called action abstractions. Like if you are building some payroll system, financial system, you would be posting debit credit entry. That is a event abstraction. So these are the main abstractions we use in our system. Let me give you one more real world example. When we are building some application, all applications need some kind of logging, some kind of exception handling, some kind of data access, authentication, authorization. What we do is we abstract these key requirements of our application. Logging, okay, we'll use some Microsoft logging block, or we may use log4net. So that will take care of taking the information, and we can configure whether it need to be stored in the database, in the file. If there's exception, we need email. Authentication authorization, we can plug in some components, third party or home built. So we abstract certain details so that we can focus on the identifying the domain. That is the clean architecture where we first focus on the business, because business, this is the most identifying abstraction in the problem domain is the most important thing that can decide the success or failure of the project. So once we have found out abstractions in our system, next thing is to encapsulate them. Encapsulate them into the classes that has public properties and behavior. So they have state and behavior. For example, patient may have a ID, name, address, and you may add methods. Okay, a patient is added to our system. You may update information of the patient to the system. So that is an encapsulation. Encapsulation is packaging these abstractions into structure, common structure, which has a state and behavior. Once we have identified abstractions, we have encapsulated into classes. So what are the public behavior? What is the behavior that should be shown to clients? And there may be some details which we need only internally that should be hidden. Microservices architecture is a very big example of this concept, this technique. In microservices, suppose we have a client which will give us patient ID and get the patient history. So in the microservices architecture, that call will come over HTTP. So it will be a REST HTTP call. And the client doesn't care that microservices has been written in C#, Java, Python, whichever technology it has been written, how we are accessing the database, what kind of database we have. We have Oracle, SQL Server, how we are accessing the database. Are we using object relational mapper or some kind of stored procedure? I would prefer object relational mapper, prefer personally for development and maintenance. So the point is, all this information can be hidden from the client. Client just call a microservice and gets the job done. So once we have identified abstraction, encapsulated into classes, decided what information should be public for the component or the classes, next comes into modularity. Modularity is the process where we put these abstractions into packages or component or subsystems. The modularity is making sure that these classes are subdivided into components, packaged into the components. So these components are the physical containers of the functionality. So that helps to the maintain. Like, let's example, like in an enterprise, we may have a patient history application, we may have a billing application, inventory application. So within we can pack build application for these departments and use. Next one is separation of concerns. In separation of concerns, we make sure that classes the classes who have similar responsibilities are clubbed together. Let's take a layered architecture. In layered architecture, you have a presentation layer, you have a business layer, you have data access layer. So all the classes, all the logic which is related to the presentation, which is defining how your information will be shown, that is put into the presentation layer. All the business logic, okay, how the patient is coming, encounter, that is packaged in the business layer. And finally, we have data access layer. All the data access technologies goes into the data access layer. The benefit of this layered approach or separation of concern is, if tomorrow we need to change data access layer, without affecting business layer or presentation layer, we can change the data access layer. You are using stored procedure, you want to change it with some object relation mapping. Same is about presentation layer. You had a presentation layer and now you want to change the presentation layer to, you had Angular, you want to change to React or Vue. So that would not affect business layer or data access layer. Another example is model view controller architecture. In model, all your business logic goes to the model, and controller is the one which get the request from the client. It manipulates the model and decides which view will be using and provides the model information to the view to be shown. So that's another very good example where we have separated the concern. Business logic goes to the business objects, go to the model, presentations goes to the view, and controller is doing all the magic. So that maintenance is easy and you can write more tests easily. The next technique is coupling and cohesion. Coupling is how much association two components have. If they are too much association, for example, you don't maintain a layered architecture. You write all your presentation layer, business layer, data access layer inside a component inside one class form, then you're tightly coupling the code. So which is bad, because if we want to change the data access tomorrow, because of the tight coupling, you cannot change it. So the good, such a good idea is there should be like these components should be lightly covered. You should have different layers, like presentation layer in presentation code should be in presentation layer, business code should be in business layer, and data access should be in data access layer. And you should be using interfaces to make sure they are not tightly coupled to each other. And you can change the data access layer without affecting the presentation layer or the business layer. And next is cohesion. Cohesion is how similar your classes are in the package. So you have some project billing application, so like patient history application. So we have to make sure that only the classes which are relevant to billing or pertaining to patient history are in this package. If there are some inventory classes, maybe that should go to in that different package. So we need to have as much as possible the cohesive code, related code together in the package. So that that way is, again, the maintenance is easy. So suppose you have to find some code related to inventory. You just go to the inventory package, inventory project, or inventory namespace, and make changes there. And so that whereas in the patient history you have only the classes which you need for that subsystem. Separation of policy and implementation. Eight technique is separation of policy and implementation. So what does this principle says is the component which has policy information, context information, they should be different. And the components which implement the algorithm or implementation, they should be different. So let's see into strategy design pattern. It will make more sense. In strategy design pattern, there are multiple factors. First factor is context. So context class is the one which invokes a strategy interface, and in this it will call a strategy interface to do some method, and there will be actual implementation, the strategy one, strategy two, to do operation. So we have a context, it calls a strategy interface to call a strategy one, strategy two. Let's take examples. Suppose we are calculating some payroll. So the strategy would be calculating a payroll, and there would be different calculations for manager, and there would be different calculations for some regular employee. So this context employees tell the strategy which package to invoke, which calculation to invoke. For manager, it will tell, okay, there's a manager, this employee's manager, give me his salary calculation, or if it is not manager, give me a regular employee calculations. Sufficiency, completeness, and primitiveness. What this technique means is that component should have sufficient information about abstraction to do the operation, and it should have the complete information about the abstraction. We are giving patient history, we need to know patient name, his diagnosis, when he was admitted. So our system should capture all information about the abstraction which we need to do the job. And primitive means it should be simple enough to do the job. Ninth principle is separation of interface and implementation. So we saw in previous example how you can have light coupling, or when you use an interface between client and implementation. So any component has two parts. One is interface, and one is implementation. Interface is like I'm making a contract to a client application. Okay, you give me these parameters, you call this method, and I'll return this information. So generally, client should be coded against this interface. The benefit of keeping interface and implementation different is we can change the implementation. We can have a better algorithm. Let's take microservice example. As long we are supporting a function call, we can change the technology. We can change the database access technology. We can. 10th technique is single point of reference. There should be single point of reference and single declaration of a type in the system. But a lot of languages like C++, they allow only one definition of a type, but you can declare it multiple times. The final principle is divide and conquer. Using divide and conquer, we can divide a big problem into small problems. Let's say enterprise, we can break a enterprise into different departments and we can create different packages, different solutions for each department, like patient history, billing, inventory. And within patient history, we can break again component into multiple modules. So benefit of dividing and conquering is you can divide the complexity in small tasks and divide among the team. How do you eat an elephant? You eat one bite at a time. If you like this video, like it, share it, and subscribe to this channel for your regular updates. Also connect with me on LinkedIn and Twitter, especially LinkedIn. If you like small summaries of the video, I will be posting a lot of small summaries of the video on LinkedIn. Thanks again.